we are gonna write a three line poem. Okay, so the first line is gonna be like about your emotions. So let's say my feeling is happiness. So when I talk about happiness, I'm gonna think about a color which I feel really connected with, like which I can relate to happiness. I like the pride. I like all of the colors. So I will say happiness is as colorful as rainbow. Deepak, give me a feeling.
Enthusiasm.
So enthusiasm is as any, like shout out some colors, anyone.
Blue.
Okay, enthusiasm is as blue as
blue.
As blue as
sky.
So it is an example. Enthusiasm is as blue as sky. So write your first poem down, first line down. We are gonna move on towards our second line of the poem. So when I talk about happiness, it might sound to me like maybe the sound of the rain. What do we call the sound of a rain when like we hear tip? Okay, so I might use the happiness sounds like tip of the rain to me, or the pitter-patter of the rain.
See, I chose something that is not as happy. I chose sorrow. What does sorrow sound like? What does it look like for me? I want you to describe it for me, right? So whoever is reading your poem is getting a clearer idea of what you want to express. So for example, maybe sorrow to me is the sound of a child crying.
What is that? हवा चलती है तो विंडो नहीं खड़ा होता है, जब कुछ ज़्यादा तूफान आती है तब राइट, सो मे बी ड्यूरिंग अ थंडरस्टॉर्म समथिंग ऑन दैट, लाइक मेक इट एज डिस्क्रिप्टिव एज पॉसिबल, राइट? यू हैव गुड आइडियाज एक्चुअली.
पास दो.
अमेरिकन.
सो वी आर गोना मूव टुवर्ड्स द थर्ड लाइन.
फियर फील्स लाइक आई एम ट्रैप्ड इन अ स्मॉल रूम. व्हेन आई रीड योर पोएम डज इट टेल मी मोर अबाउट यू? कैन आई फाइंड आउट व्हाट इज हैप्पीनेस फॉर कौशिक? कैन आई फाइंड आउट व्हाट इज loneliness for K? Can I find these things from your three line poem is my question.
It feels like finding an inner eyes. There's no one to hold me. So I love the first line, but I can't see the relation. But I like the
line. Yeah, there's rhyme scheme.
You don't have to focus on the rhyme.
Feel it.
Great, so that readers can experience the emotion that you're experiencing. Alright, which brings us to the second one also. Metaphors and similes. When you're comparing something to something else, it gives you a clearer idea. And the third one, share your story. Now trust me, I can teach you 10 tools which are very, very technical in nature, but if it is not your story that you're sharing, then it is not your poem that you're writing. Because remember again, like we mentioned, freedom to each of us is different. I can't write your story for you.
So we are gonna write another poem on freedom.
You can write in any language that you want to write. So for this poem, we're not restricting you to English alone. And second, you don't have to worry about having a rhyme scheme or not having a rhyme scheme. Like, we read different poems and they didn't have a lot of rhyme schemes, right? Let your feelings out the way they come.
So the first thing would be clarity. So you have to be clear enough so that everyone here can understand what you are saying. And the second thing is voice modulation. You have to use your voice according to the poem, according to the emotion of the poem.
The atom molecules are free to go anywhere. Okay, I have just considered the sign. So want freedom to talk, want freedom to walk, need freedom to teach and need freedom to sneeze. Life does not complete freedom, but freedom completes life. It makes us self-possessed. If used for giving rights, then I am the most beautiful heaven. But if used for giving no right, then I am the most worst hell. Want freedom to talk, want freedom to walk, need freedom to teach and need freedom to sneeze.
मैं नारी हूँ एक शतज नहीं, काम धारणा का रूप हूँ मैं, ना मैं जाति हूँ ना मैं कोई धर्म का प्रतीक हूँ, मैं तो मनुष्यता का प्रमाण हूँ. मैं नारी हूँ एक शतज नहीं, काम धारणा का रूप हूँ, मैं लोगों की मनोबलता हूँ, मैं लोगों की परेशानियों का हल हूँ. मैं कोई दासी नहीं एक नारी हूँ, ना मैं शतज का प्रतिकूल हूँ, मैं एक नारी हूँ प्रतिकूल की, मैं स्वयं भविष्य की धारणा का रूप हूँ. मैं नारी बंधन की गूंज हूँ, रात की शीतल हवा का झोंका हूँ. मैं नारी हूँ कोई तुलसी मटका नहीं, मैं मही की ज्वाला हूँ, मनुष्य की वाणी का प्रतीक हूँ. पर कोई दोष नहीं मैं नारी हूँ, एक कलंक नहीं गौरव का मुखड़ा हूँ. मैं नारी हूँ एक शतज नहीं, काम धारणा का रूप.
इस पोम का नाम है के आवाजें. मुझे बहुत तेज कदमों की आवाजें सुनाई देती हैं, मानो किसी की ट्रेन छूट रही हो, मानो जैसे कोई खुद को ढूंढने के लिए भाग रहा हो. भगदड़ मची हुई है, बहुत तेजी से सब लोग भाग रहे हैं. कुछ लोग रुकना चाहते हैं पर नहीं रुक सकते, क्योंकि पीछे से धक्का महसूस होता है. लगता है जैसे रुके तो लोग कुचल दिए जाएंगे, शरीर के साथ सपनों को भी तोड़ दिया जाएगा. सपने जो मुर्दा हैं पर अभी भी साथ हैं. मन में डर है कि रुके तो लोग कोसना शुरू कर देंगे, गालियां देंगे. ये भगदड़ कभी नहीं रुकती, पर रात के समय आपको एक मौका मिल जाता है कि आप लोगों से छुप छुपा के दुबकते हुए चेहरे पे नकाब पहन के रुक सकते हैं, किसी कोने में बात कर सकते हो खुद से, पर शर्तें लागू हैं. भाग सकते हो आप इस भगदड़ से, सवालों से भागना इतना आसान नहीं. सवाल जो सालों से जवाब ढूंढ रहे हैं, भीख मांग रहे हैं, सवाल ऐसे जिनका जवाब गले में अटका हुआ है पर जुबा पे नहीं आता. ये नौकरी छोड़ क्यों नहीं देते, क्यों कविताएं अपनी किसी को नहीं पढ़ने देते, क्यों नहीं अब्बू को ये बताया कि इंजीनियर नहीं बनना मुझे, क्यों नहीं कहते कि मुझे शिवानी नहीं उसका भाई पसंद है, फर्क नहीं पड़ता पुल्लिंग या स्त्रीलिंग. इतनी देर क्यों कर दी, अब इन सवालों से दम घुटता है. लगता है अब जवाब मिले तो समाज की घड़ी रुक जाएगी, घड़ों के शीशे टूटने लगेंगे, लोग गालियां देंगे, मगर डर के मारे मौत आ जाएगी, और अगर जवाब नहीं मिले तो घुटन से मरना होगा. पर सच्चाई ये नहीं, सच्चाई तो यह है जवाब मिलते ही सब चीजें मायने नहीं रखेंगी, शीशों की मरम्मत फिर से हो जाएगी, लोगों की गालियों को हम दिल से नहीं लगाएंगे, नजरअंदाज कर देंगे, घड़ी के कांटों को हम धक्का मार चला देंगे और इस नकाब को दूर फेंक देंगे, कहीं पहाड़ों में वादियों में और एक गहरी सी सांस लेंगे.
Is something that Sanjana Didi is going to be doing for you.
Okay guys, it's been your last day in school as a class together, so I've written something for each and every student. Thank you Krishna for showing me resilience, entering a new class of boys and making new friends among strangers. Thank you Nitesh for pushing my creativity and always giving me a thumbs up when I didn't believe in myself. Thank you, Praveen, for showing me academics is not the only thing that shapes a person. Prashant, namaste. For all the smiles that lit up my day, thank you for being so cute. Rohit Kane, where to start? Thank you for challenging my ideologies, my beliefs, for making me a better person. Rohit Verma, you were my teacher when it came to being brave about sharing emotions with the class. Saurabh, last warning. Out of the class. Thank you for testing my patience and helping me grow. Shivam, thank you for making me believe in innocence and true love for both your bhaiyas and your didis. Sumit, thank you for being the peace we all sought on days of chaos. Vineet, where is Vineet? Can I get a smile from you, please?
Yes.
Thank you for always having that reassuring smile in the middle of a complete breakdown of class. Thank you to Vivek for making me laugh and showing me that spaces of learning are not restricted to four walls. Thank you, Aniket, for teaching me loyalty towards your friends. Aryan, thank you for the constant fashion statements. Nakul, thank you for being my carbon copy throughout these 2 years. And I hope you continue to love economics. Akhil, you make me believe in a reimagined education, not limited to the pages of a textbook. Deepak,
I will only say one thing to you. Freddie Mercury once said, music is limitless. I'll tell you now, Deepak, you are limitless. Manav, thank you for always being yourself, even when they told you to change, even when the world told you to change. Thank you, Rohit Kumar, for making me believe that all kids have potential in them. Ankit, thank you for raising your hand to speak or ask doubts, which honestly I was super scared of. Nitesh Kumar and Agaz, thank you for all the smiles you gave to me during class to make me remember I'm teaching kids. Class 10, thank you for 2 years of memories. I will never forget you all.